In this Blender tutorial, I'm going to show you how to clean up an Artec Leo structured light scan for remeshing and export into Fusion 360. In the previous video, we set up our scan, imported it, scaled it properly, and made a backup duplicate. This original backup duplicate is very important if we want to transfer any of the textures over from the original scan. Once we start sculpting, anything with Dyna topology or moving the polygons around will destroy the UV mapping, so it's important to have a backup. Some of the things we need to fix on this scan are these overlapping pieces that hang out in the space. This is really hard to remesh, and it's just going to confuse everything and is adding unneeded polygons. So we'll delete those. We'll use a variety of techniques to eliminate objects. One way is we can tab into edit mode and eliminate large pieces. So for example, these things that are hanging out into space, they can either be selected in edit mode and deleted, or they can be tried to sculpt down. A nice way is to go ahead and try to sculpt things, and then if it doesn't work when you're sculpting, pop into edit mode and cut those pieces off. Another place is to look inside places that the scan might seem like it is perfect, but is bad. The scans from the Artec Leo come in manifold, so they're watertight. You can see this cavity here. So if I go inside the mesh, and then I orbit around, you'll see that there's this extra protrusion inside the mouth that the structured light scanned. So we want to eliminate that because this is just going to be difficult for any remeshing or other program to deal with. You can select 3 and then select these faces. Press X and delete vertices. Be careful only to select the faces you want to delete. X, delete vertices. Then select this object. Press L to select all of them. Once you're confident that it's only selecting this piece, press X, delete vertices. Now there's a hole to fill in, but that's really easy to fix because I can just come down here and there's a variety of ways to do this. And I can just select A and then press F. And it'll fill in that hole. Let's see some other ways to clean up the mesh. I'm going to tab back into object mode. Then I'll select sculpt mode. And because we have a backup of this head scan in the original location, we don't have to worry about Dyna topology changing the UVs or anything like that. So I'll click Dyna topo and I'll say OK. One thing to be careful with Dyna topology is the farther you are away, the less resolution. And then when you're very close, the more resolution. So it's dynamic. So just be careful and aware of what you're doing. Here we can see these pieces that we don't want to have. And we're going to go ahead and see if we can smooth those out. With any of the sculpting tools, if you hold shift, it automatically defaults to smoothing. Then I can just smooth this out. Here we can see something that often happens with sculpting is you get these little points. Sometimes you can click and build up some mesh and then smooth them away. Other times you need to go into edit mode and delete them. I'll show you how to do that when a more troublesome one pops up. I'll keep moving around the mesh and smoothing these out. Hold the shift key to smooth, and then that looks nice there. Look at this piece here. We want to get rid of this. If I press smooth, it may or may not go away. As you can see, it's creating this point. So I may not be able to make that only with the sculpting, but I'll try one more time. If I just sculpt a little around it and then smooth it out, it goes away. These pieces will probably be a bit more difficult to get rid of with sculpting. So let's see. You can see how they're hanging off so much. So we can click smooth and smooth them out. And as I do that, you can see that this is just getting all messed up and thin. So we probably want to zoom in and then get rid of this piece. But let's see what happens if I just smooth it down and see if I can find the original part that it's connecting to the mesh. Right here is where it's connecting. So sometimes using the smooth command can highlight where those problems are. So I need to disconnect all of this and delete it. But by smoothing it out, it's showing me where I need to delete. So now I can tab into edit mode, orbit around, select faces. Sometimes it's hard to navigate around, so click the part that you want, then go to view and frame selected. Now I can orbit around this small part, then just remember to unframe selected or frame all when you're done. So now I can select these pieces and delete them. X, delete vertices, select some more of the faces. The goal here is just to make a separation, so we can use L to select all and then delete it. Press X, delete vertices. Then I can click this one, press L. Now I know all of that is selected, press X, vertices. Now I can do this one right here. And it doesn't matter where I cut it off, I can come up here and delete these faces, X, vertices, delete the rest of these faces right here. If you're ever unsure of what you're doing, just go ahead and orbit around a bit. And then you can see, for example, this face still needs to be selected. X vertices. This is probably separated now. X vertices. Now I have that a little bit better. Probably need to go back more, but we'll see what happens when we go smooth that out. Might be able to sculpt over that. We also have this section here that needs to be removed, and you can repeat that process. As you can see, that was all hanging down the shirt like that. All I need to do is tab back out into sculpt mode, click Dyna topology, select OK, and I'll show you another problem that may happen when you're sculpting. So we just deleted this, right? And now I'm going to say, okay, I'll smooth this out. And as I do that, it does smooth, but because of that hole, it may not operate correctly. As you can see, it's behaving strangely. And sometimes that closes up and other times it doesn't. So before you start sculpting again, it's generally a good idea to go ahead and fill those holes in. As you can see, it created this really strange shape, and you're just going to waste a lot of time messing with that. Go ahead and tab back into edit mode, select 3, select the faces that you need to delete, press X, vertices, select 2, grab one of those edges that you need to delete. Sometimes it gets so wonky that you can't even select it. Press L, those are all those edges, press X, delete vertices. And this time I'll press A and then F to fill in that hole. That's always a good practice before you start sculpting again, is to fill in those holes. Press tab again. I'm going to click Dyna topology, orbit around and see other parts to fix. Another thing to pay attention to, especially in these 3D scans, are these back faces. So we can smooth those out. And then up in the hair, there's often a lot of cavities and places that get filled in. And since we're going to be using these for making molds, we want to smooth this out. And even if you were just making a 3D print, it would be nice to have a lot of this smooth, and then you can sculpt it later. The goal is to have a nice base mesh that you can use for many projects. So look around for anything that might be an undercut or a strange protrusion. A lot of times it's helpful to go inside the mesh. So if I go inside here and I orbit around, now I can work inside the mesh and see things that may be beneficial. And if you're having trouble orbiting, since we framed this section here, we can go to View, Frame All. Now that frames everything. And if I tab in object mode, select this view, frame selected. Now we're only working with this. Go back to sculpt mode. Make sure Dyna topology is selected. Press OK. Now I'm going to go inside and try to clean up some of the hair. And as you'll see, there'll be some obvious places that you might not notice from the outside. For example, this right here is a big nub. We want to get rid of those things by pressing the smooth command. And then also you can see these tunnels. So for example, this right here, it's just going to give a lot of problems later. So go ahead and smooth a lot of this out ahead of time before we do any of our remeshing. So I'm going to go ahead and finish cleaning this up and then show you basics of when you want to start remeshing. Here's another example of a place that we want to remesh. This isn't any good for 3D printing or anything. It's just strange geometry. You can either cut it off in edit mode or try to build around it in sculpt mode. Sometimes building around it in sculpt mode is faster. Other times it just makes a mess. So depending on how your mesh is situated, you can use either way of cleaning that up. Another thing to look out for is holes in your mesh. So here I have a hole in the ear. So I need to re-sculpt that, and I'm missing a piece. So here I can just build up more clay or digital polygons. This is especially helpful in the Dyna topology. Make sure you orbit around to see what you're doing. And you can build that up and smooth it out to way you need to for your ear or any other thing that has an unnecessary hole. We can also build this up quickly, and then it can be smoothed out, filled in some more. If you're having trouble getting the hole to fill in, you can always go ahead in edit mode and then bridge those and then fill the holes. Depends on what process is going to be faster for getting your shape. Now that hole is smoothed in, and I can continue moving around and checking the mesh. So go around and check all the places that are problematic in your mesh and clean them up until you're satisfied. In the next video, I'll discuss how to prepare this cleaned up mesh for remeshing and eventual export for import into Fusion 360. Happy 3D modeling.